All right, this is Eric again. What I have here is I have a little short dilemma. This branch that's coming down right here, that's actually holding this whole piece up from falling down. So, like, when I wiggle it, that whole branch moves. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut sections of this off. Cut another piece off of here so it don't smash down on the fence. Cut this and maybe cut that piece right there. Cut it at the elbow. And hopefully, I'm gonna try to cut it back another piece to where this arm will just slide over this way and it won't actually have too much weight on the fence. And I also have my Porta wrap here. Porta wrap and whoopee, and also have my 3/4 inch CMI block as well. So I'm gonna do some rigging if I need to rig this out. Have my Buckingham spikes.
Oh.
it knocked out only one centerpiece block, I mean, board. So I just had to go to Home Depot and get that one board to replace up there. So, what I'm going to do is go ahead and chop off another section right here.
Thank you.
gonna swing on here, but this is, even though this is a small piece that I'm cutting, I'm pretty sure this has a lot of weight to it. It's probably gonna swing back towards my ladder. So what I'm about to do now is position my ladder on the other side so it, when it swings out, it'll swing right here and it's open and not hit the fence and not hit me on the ladder. So I'm gonna be on the other side. Definitely didn't want that to come down. And even though this is a small piece, this wood is very heavy. Very heavy. So now I'm just gonna lower it. Towards the tree.
here on this side and the other side. So this cut I'm about to make, I should, like I say, this piece with this weight off of here, this should actually just fall straight back. And this maybe just lean right here on the fence, or it might slide down. But either way, the weight off of it's where it shouldn't do damage to where it takes the whole fence down. Get a good look at this. Okay. There's a notch in both sides, top and bottom. So I should actually be clear to where once this is cut, it should just drop. It's gonna clear the fence. This right here should actually be should be fine. So we're gonna see how this actually plays out. We're gonna watch that from right there. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna go ahead and cut this portion of this leg off right here to get this off of this fence. And we should be good. And then I'm gonna get up in a tree and take that down.
Ah, 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 ah.
as you can see right here, I just cut that off of the fence right there. Like I say, it did bring down, the first one brought down that one piece. I will go to Home Depot right after this, get one board and replace that. All right, now what I'm about to do now, I'm gonna pause it right here. I'm gonna gas up my my Husqvarna again. I'm gonna gas it up, put some more oil, boil oil in here. And like I say, this is my CS271T 14 inch Echo chainsaw. I also have my CMI three quarter inch block 9/16 rigging rope. And here we have my Porta wrap right here, my Porta wrap, and then I have my Buckingham tree spikes. So basically what I'm gonna do after I gas up, this is a pretty heavy, significant piece of log right here. And like I say, it's hanging by the bark. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna come from the top end down, I'm gonna rig it around this top end section right here. So therefore, when I make the cut up here, it doesn't hit the bottom, and then this top end falls back into the fence. I don't wanna do any fence damage. So therefore, by me rigging it, once I cut it, it'll stand still. And if anything, just swing that way. And I can go ahead and lower it and have it go down out this direction right here. So I'm gonna take a break real quick and I'm gonna come back with the final part right here.